like to draw your attention today to an extremely serious and grave issue that has very portentous constitutional ramifications. If the reports which are appearing in the public space are correct, that on the 1st of February 2019, the NDA-BJP government is planning to present a full-fledged union budget, then it would be a flagrant violation of all parliamentary conventions, procedures, and traditions which have been followed over the past seven decades, ever since the Constitution of India came into effect. The NDA-BJP government does not have the electoral mandate, and it does not have the electoral legitimacy to present six full budgets in 5 years. If you recall, when the NDA-BJP government assumed office in the May of 2014, they presented a budget for the financial year 2014-15, 2015-16, 2016-17, 2017-18, and 2018-19. The NDA-BJP government has already presented five full-fledged union budgets, and it does not have the mandate or the legitimacy to present a sixth budget. The financial year 2019 would commence on the 1st of April 2019. And it continues till the 31st of March 2020. The tenure of this government comes to an end on the 26th of May 2019. A new government will have to assume office before the 26th of May 2019. So, a government which is going to be in office for a mere 46 days from the 1st of April 2019, how does it have the legitimacy, leave alone the mandate, to present a budget for 365 days? When you don't have a tenure, where do you derive the locus to present a budget for 365 days? And then there are laid down procedures. Once a union budget is presented, it goes to the respective departmental related standing committees. The standing committees scrutinize the budget proposals of every ministry. They report back to Parliament, and only after that is the finance bill adopted and passed. In any case, whenever a union budget is presented, the union government also presents a vote on account to cater for the contingency between the presentation and the passage of the budget. And if the NDA-BJP government, which of course has rightly earned the title of being an institutional slayer, was to throw all parliamentary conventions, all propriety, all traditions to the winds, because motivated by electoral opportunism, motivated by populism, cognizant of the fact that they have completely destroyed the Indian economy over the past 55 months, demonetization, a badly implemented GST, completely no job creation at all. If they were to commit this travesty, another institution, the temple of Indian democracy, the Parliament of India, would stand completely undermined. This perhaps would be the biggest blow that would be inflicted by the NDA-BJP government on not only what constitutes an electoral mandate, but the powers and responsibilities which flow out of that electoral mandate, which gives the government a maximum term of 5 years. So, in the dying days of this government, knowing fully well that they are on their way out, the Indian National Congress strongly demands that the NDA-BJP government follow constitutional propriety and only present a vote on account on the 1st of February 2019. They should desist from presenting a full-fledged budget, and were that to happen, it would be strongly opposed both on the floor of the House and outside.